truly, truly, if you've never been here before, welcome for the first time, and like, please come back all the time. There's a lot of familiar faces, and it's really great to see you tonight. If you don't know us, we are a literary nonprofit. We are 10 years old this year. We've always been. We are based in Dallas. We've always been based in Dallas. And as of 2020, we became the world's largest publisher of literature and translation. It's very cool. And it's especially exciting to have such a Dallas-based event about a work from so far away. It's very, I don't know, accurate to the mission. I'm actually going to let you talk about it.
Okay.
Gregg, Jesse, Aliana, thank you so much for being here. Without further ado.
I'm just going to say a couple of quick words because I think they might enhance the process. I know it's not that helpful sometimes to hear how the sausage is made, but what we're doing here, the idea for this project came about, is inspired by the work of Amang and her book Raised by Wolves, and it's originally in Mandarin. And the idea that language can make us think different, can allow us to think differently, can influence our behavior, inspired me to want to try and do this. And my responses are going to be based on what I hear. I'm not going to know. I haven't memorized the poems. I don't even know what she's going to say. And she being Jesse, who we're very, very fortunate to be. She doesn't know me at all, which is probably helpful in her agreeing to do this. But it's really a great honor, and I really appreciate it. Just out of the blue, she was able to help us out. And without further ado, afterwards, if you have any questions about process, I'm very interested in the process of improvising, and what it's all about. I'll shut up now and we'll get going, okay? Changing these things on and off, so there's not really any delicate way to do it with a hat, but the hat keeps me from being able to see how you guys are responding to what I'm doing, so that's helpful for me.
Not yet. 有一个吻, 还没到。 半路弯腰，捡拾掉落的包袱。裙裾上碎玻璃及马粪，小甲虫的春天。提液横流，横着流。鱼戏莲叶不变方向，影响力不变方向。井上之指印只不易维持，不变方向。但所有柳树又发了芽。或许他为乘马南来展览着江南风景，那么个角色。 天地皆黑，我两手垂下，不承认那也是我最爱乘坐的木马。
Thank you. There's a kiss which still in transit stoops to gather up its bundle of effects, the skirt caked with horse shit and slivers of broken glass, the juices of a beetled spring flooding, carp frolic among the lotus leaves, this way and that, allurement, this way and that, prints on a clavicle, slipping through your fingers this way and that. Willow buds are bursting, or else it's just a pageant staged by this man on horseback approaching our luscious southern clime. Oh, these dark and silent types. The light fails, my hands fall, and I refuse to say yes, this is my favorite carousel as well.
冰，手伸入老虎嘴里，探进去掏他的心脏。我也这样从一本书切下冰，好烫。我尖起嘴，抽着蓬蓬升起来的烟。这另类疗法是住我地下室的巫婆教的。我俩长得越来越像，月经同一天开始。我没收她租金，她教我治疗脸上两大伤口。在灵魂被称出净重21克以前的古代，这两个曾被称作灵魂之窗。上个月我擦窗7次，这个月台风季我得更加小心，免得海水倒灌损毁凉亭。
Thrusting your hand down a tiger's throat to tear out his heart. So too, I cut from a book, a sheet of ice, how it burns, I round my lips, expel a plume of smoke, an alternative therapy. The witch which lives in my basement taught me the two of us grow more and more alike. Our periods now start on the same day. I don't take a penny for rent. She has taught me a timely cure for curing the two gaping wounds on my face. Wherein lies the soul weighing 21 grams, or so was believed, the so-called window to the soul. This past month, I washed them 7 times. In typhoon season, I must take extra care, lest saltwater intrusion harm the fertile fields.
如果有一天我的记忆力变好了，好到我不必去看你，也不想，我们可以永远不相见，一点也不会感到遗憾。只用一天，我在仓库里囤积的粮食已经足够对付不管多少年。每一次突然降临的饥荒，这些存粮不怕黑暗，不会受潮，不腐烂也不发芽，怎么吃都吃不完，也不腻。如果有一天我的记忆力变好了，我说过我的记性很差。 到目前为止，多少年了，我们只见过一次。我们只在一起一天。那时你好像也顺便提了一下，你的记性不会比我好。万一有一天你的记忆力变好了呢？
So good, I wouldn't have this need to see you. Might not even want to. So good that if we never met again, I wouldn't have a single qualm. What I would have harvested that day could well fill a silo enough to weather the longest famine. What I would have reaped would not fear the dark, would never decompose, grow stale, or sprout, avoiding any chance of toxic offshoots, would never run out, would never cloy. Oh, if only one day my memory were good. I think I mentioned I have a wretched memory in all these years. We met only once, had but one day together, rounded off to the nearest whole number. I vaguely recall your mentioning your memory was worse than mine. If by chance you do remember everything one day, what then?
我紧紧抱你的时候，这世界好多人死；我紧紧抱你的时候，这世界好多人饿死；我紧紧抱你的时候，这世界好多人战死；我紧紧抱你的时候，这世界好多人发生意外死了；我紧紧抱你的时候，这世界好多人自己帮助自己死去；环抱自己的手一下子放松，我不抱世界这么多没有呼吸了的人。 我抱你就抱着感觉窒息，在我紧紧也被你紧紧地抱住这时候，这么多人感觉不到，我们濒临真空拔高的爱情的颤抖，潮浪越过了石堆，那么多现在不动声色，被搬动的石头下一刻，爱能不能下一刻，更多不动被搬动的石头，没有答案，不要有。 我知道我们能不能在互相紧紧抱着，是我不知道的。或者在某个人停下来想下一个字，一颗炮弹在空中优美的划过，一滴水饱满的腾跃，潜水艇安安静静，地雷乖巧，扫干净的地灰尘争相落下，草籽儿精神好绿。
thousands are dying all over the world. As we embrace thousands are dying of starvation, as we embrace thousands are dying in wars, as we embrace thousands are dying in violent accidents, as we embrace thousands are having a hand in their deaths with a final hug before letting go, I can't embrace those who are no longer breathing. I embrace you embracing me till we can barely breathe. This here, this now, so many can no longer feel us. Shuddering with love on the verge of being lifted into that one true nothingness. Waves sweeping over stony rubble. Unmoved and silent from this moment on, will love enable or is love unable? From this moment on, will these stones remain so unmoved, so silent? There is no answer. I don't want an answer, but I do. I know my knowing whether we will ever be able to embrace like this again is a great unknown. Just imagine someone pausing to consider their next word. A cannon shot tracing a graceful arc across the sky. A tiny sphere of water rising in the air. A quiescent submarine, a well-mannered landmine. The dust vying to be the first to soil a well-swept floor.
今天的雨不是被想要的雨，它下着妈妈的舌头，赤裸裸，没有加密，从我们看腻了的云。今天的雨，它没有说好听的、新鲜的，让我们一听就热极了的，像Siri会讲的那种话。今天的雨，它下着妈妈的舌头，重重的，种种的，它问我一个蠢问题。 你要选可以吃的苹果，还是不可以吃的苹果？
The rain today is not the rain one longs for. She showers us with mother tongues, raw, unencrypted, from clouds we've long grown weary of. The rain today does not regale us with sexy new phrases that fire up our engines the way Siri does when she does what she does. The rain today showers us with mother tongues, heavy, inflated, inflamed. She asks me a silly question. Do you prefer an apple you can eat or an apple you can't?
Kiss. 在我和这池蜜之间，没有蜜蜂细的足以穿越。即使蜜蜂的梦也不行，即使一只正在做梦的蜜蜂，它吹玻璃一样吹成嘴里弹簧，吹着每朵花开，吹出了整座花园。如果这时有人伸手关掉世界，唯一的嗡嗡声发自我和哈美。
Spoonful of honey, there is no honeybee small enough to pass, or even the dream of a honeybee, or a honeybee dreaming of unfurling its tongue like a grasshopper, trumpeting flower after flower, a garden in bloom. If someone were to turn off the world, the only sound you'd hear would be the humming coming from me and my honey spoon.
我们对植物的研究进入田野的实地调查，水花淤积的地方就是河床。伸出绿手指，你朝河床边画边写。圆构成水，三角构成花。圆和三角互相渗透，组织淤积。二月，我们到冲击的田野采集。
February, expanse of riverbed and river bottom, tendrils spread, water comes to a boil, blooms, and so we begin our botanical inquiry, enter into the spirit of it, survey the lay of the land. The place where it blooms, where it silts up, is the riverbed. Extending your hand, your green thumb, you face the bed and paint a picture. As you write, circles make water, a triangle, a flower. Their mutual penetration brings a new order to things, rich deposits. February, we sample the alluvial fields.
这是我留在相片外的原因吗？我对到他的眼睛的时候，他正在一张相片里头。那不是他最远的旅行，也不是我的，但有种震动让我写下，想切入乳酪蛋糕，碰到了饼干底。
Is this why I stayed outside the frame? When our eyes met, he had just stepped into the picture. It was not the farthest he had come, nor the farthest I had gone, but something moved me to write these lines, like cutting cheesecake and arriving at the crust.
Do a costume change here.
Thank you.
狼养的。三个月爸妈没有下山，米店不肯再赊账，我没力气爬树跑步，祖母牵我爬到河边喝个饱。他来了，很小的时候我摸着天摇摇晃晃，正在学走的女孩倒映在他眼里被云包覆，那是我。他从山上的大岩块跳向海边的砾滩，给砾石带来火，海水发烫，祖母的床也整晚沸腾，我听见他们睡在一起。可惜我终于睡着，直到脚边堆着暖乎乎刚被杀死的鸡羊，还有我最爱吃的海鱼。祖母又生起炉火忙碌起来，树上猴子跳来跳去，一匹野马冲破了墙，那是我狼养的。
raised by wolves. 3 months had passed, and Ma and Pa had not come down the mountain. The local grocery would no longer honor our IOUs. I hadn't the strength to run or climb a tree. Granny led me to the water to drink my fill. Then it came. I am very small. I reach for the sky as I wobble back and forth. A child, just learning how to stagger, reflected in its eye, embraced by clouds in the sky. That's me. From its mountain lair, it came bounding down to the gravelly shore, setting land and sea on fire, making Granny's bed boil and seethe. I hear them going at it all night long. But then I fall asleep and wake to find heaped at my feet freshly slaughtered chicken and sheep and all the fish I love to eat. Granny is bustling around the fire, a monkey's leaping from tree to tree, a Mustang busting through the wall. That's me, raised by wolves.
Thank you.
Because
literally,
we're gonna pass around a hat. All this money goes to these wonderful people who did all of this wonderful everything. If you want to support this bookstore, buy a book. You could even buy the book that you just heard. I realized that I did not give a very good introduction of it before, but this is a translation event. You've heard various translations of a novel. The author, the original author and the translator are not here. The original author's name is Amang. They're a Taiwanese filmmaker and poet. This is a collection of their work. They're pretty acclaimed. It's very exciting. Steve Bradbury is a translator. It came out in 2020. It won a Pan America Poetry Debut Award. So Yay Phoneme, which is the imprint that it came from, Deep Vellum Press. We know Gregg as the Greggular because he's our best regular. He's here, he like visits us regularly, usually at least buys a cup of coffee. When he gets the book, he reads it, and then he like comes and wants to talk to us about it. He is wonderful. But I will say that the Dallas Observer called him Texas's most adventurous guitarist, quote, possibly its greatest. So that's what we got to hear tonight. He just brought this event to us. It was entirely his brain, because he loved this book so much, and that it just, this is very wonderful. Thank you so much. Thank y'all so much. Yes.
The advertisement said conversations. I don't do that well. That's why I was left alone a lot as a child, and even more so as an adult. And that's why I play guitar. Sorry, Brian. You can probably hear me at midnight. Brian's
no,
neighbor.
Love it, man. It's great.
Oh, that's good. Well, then I'm not trying hard enough. I am interested in process, and so all kidding aside, I mean, are there any questions? Improvising is a special thing to me. For good or ill, it's what I like to do the most. It's why I'm broke. And but it is something that really it's I don't know, the thing I like. I said, you know, I just love it. So, I mean, any questions about process or questions about language versus, you know, how it affects anything? Different language. Any ideas? Any concerns? I've had people get angry at me. I for some of the things I've played. Literally, I've been threatened before.
Seriously, a lot.
Some of you, Mike and Paul, know who threatened me. I won't mention the name right now, but it was just.
You're still streaming.
There we go.
Turn it off.
Preparing for something like this is it does involve work. I do make this up as I go along, but a lot of it had to do, thank you again, for hearing the language. I didn't have the poetry list memorized, and some of them I can kind of tell because of the length, like one was very short, one was longer, but it's still, I don't really have time to interpret the words as I'm playing. So. Preparing for this is kind of a weird deal. I'd love any recommendations other than, you know, practice more, dude. But it's a weird thing to try and prepare for because, most of it is just you know, technique is one thing, but your ideas are the things that make you you. So there's no better you than you. I did actually meet the best guitar player in Dallas today. He came into my work, which was nice. And there are several others that are nice enough to speak to me, but I've talked to a few of them, and it's just, you know, I'll never attain a certain level of technicality, perhaps. Some of us are excel in that area, and some of us excel in other areas. So it's just a matter of finding, you know, a road to where you express yourself. And I like the immediacy of expressing myself right here, right now, without having anything prepared. Maybe that's because my memory is terrible, but not really. So any questions now? You want me to stop?
We'll still give you wine and beer and water and tea, and if there's coffee, we'll give it to you. And maybe we won't have to make them ask you on the spot.
Yeah, let's
Greg's
yeah.
not going anywhere. Mm-hmm. You don't have to sit in your seat.
I think Rick had a question.
Oh, just kidding.
So, when you listen to the reading and you improvise, you decide on the spot what you were going to play at the show.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I do.
But you hadn't heard it before tonight. That was
not certainly not in Mandarin. I've read the book.
Yeah.
And I thought about reading and really like reading the poems over and over again, but I didn't want to do that because I wanted the language to kind of push me this way or pull me that way. And honestly, I mean, I have no idea. It just sounds beautiful to me, so. I mean, I like it a lot better than English.
My favorite one was the one after, After Rain. I like that better. That was my favorite.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. Okay, well, let's
okay.
Yeah.
So is kind of the idea behind it, or do you think you're drawn to that because of the music, and do you feel like that's in some ways your language, and that's how kind of how you express yourself? Why do you feel like you're drawn to that?
The sound, okay, drawn to the language, you mean?
The idea that language shapes the way you think.
Yes, there are certain things in the book that gave me that idea. There were conversations between the author and the translator. Do you have any? I mean, I'm not trying to figure this out.
Yeah, actually, to be honest, I haven't read anything apart from what I was reading before this show. And I was just looking at this book. It's not only the poems. They also include the conversation between the Amang and her translator, which is quite interesting for them. Because for translated, just for the translation, you cannot like literally translate the language. You need to understand it, and then you discuss with the author, the poet, the Amang, and you just discuss with each other. And you express the best way to the English version. So I think it's quite interesting. It's not only the poems, also the conversations.
And that's exactly, and that answers your question, actually. For me, it's that idea that it's a conversation. And
mm-hmm.
So it's sort of a, you know, I hear it and I don't understand it, but somehow the way, you know, I've read things before, but it just, when I hear a different language than English, which is the only one I kind of speak it fluently, right? but it does make me think of things differently. I mean, I've studied some languages, you know, throughout my education, and it's just a different, it's beyond the structure, it's just the pure sound of it, I think, is what I mean, to get more of a nuts and bolts answer to what you're saying, it's like the actual sound of it hitting my ears is kind of what does it for me.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what interests me about it. And so improvising is tied directly to that. It's partly about sound, you know, just the sound of things that are happening. So
is your improvisation a translation or an expression of how you find what
yeah.
you're hearing?
Yes.
Both.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
For sure. Yeah. I mean, hopefully, I'm expressing something, but it's both things at the same time. All right.
Yeah.
Any thoughts? Any threats?
exuberations, exhortations?
I've got too many threats right now.
All right.
Well, Leanna's actually very own Deep Vellum bookseller, so if you ever want to come by when we're open any day from 12 to 6, especially on the weekends when Ellie's here, they might read you some poetry. Nice. Seen it before.
Yeah. Thank you for doing this.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Well, carry on as you work.
Move about your